So in a quick way, it's basically the first of our vision to have a retail network, the first store, which is the first step toward us having a retail network where we could distribute products outside of Best Buy, outside of Target, outside of traditional retail. Like Apple got Apple stores. American Apparel got American Apparel stores. Sanrio, like Hello Kitty, they got stores. So certain brands go to the point of creating a retail experience too. So we wanted to do that. And we wanted to be able to drop not only music, like when we did the $100 CD, imagine if I had 10 stores across the country that I could have shipped 1,000 copies to at $100 each, and we could have released it on that day simultaneously, and then I could have done my pop-up shops at my stores. And then we surround them with actually a dope streetwear line and also dope novelty items like the All Money In money counter, or like I said, the streetwear stuff, the Crenshaw sweaters or the All Money In hats and whatnot. But the main driving factor would be there's an exclusive music release that's exclusive to these stores, as opposed to being exclusive to a digital platform for a week. Imagine we can make the album exclusive to the store. You can only buy it at the Marathon store. So that's the long, big picture vision with the Marathon store. The technology aspect, which makes it a smart store, is just that all the products are encoded with content.
Yeah.
So every piece of product you buy, there's a tag on it, and it's a logo. And we, as All Money In, have the ability to upload content in real time. So you can buy the sweater today, and the tag that's hanging today will have a piece of content on it that next week I can change. And I can say, I can say, go
that's
get
your, awesome.
Yeah, and it's it's on the actual tags of the clothing. So I can say, go get your Crenshaw shirt out the dirty clothes hamper. I just uploaded the new documentary to your t-shirt.
Technology. That is so advanced. Yeah.
This clip makes me fucking mad, man. They fucking mad. This nigga... I mean, I'm mad as fuck, man. He not gonna get to see his vision, dog. That's some bullshit, like. My ducks, my swans, welcome to the pond. My name is Dorian from group82music.com. Right here, we got Nipsey talking about how he was releasing new content through his t-shirts. Man, this nigga, man, he was ahead of his time. Like, he had a long-term vision. I heard a quote today from Rashad Bilal from Earn Your Leisure. He said the average American business plans 20 years ahead. The average Chinese business plans 300 years ahead. Nigga, most of us don't even know what we're going to do tomorrow. You talking 20 years and 300 years. This nigga Nipsey was 5, 7, 10 years ahead and probably had a whole plan that he's not going to get to see happen. But the shit that he's saying, man, is like shit that Steve Jobs thinks about, like he said with Apple, right? Or like American Apparel, I don't know who their founder is, but they thought about, or even Hello Kitty, what they thought about. Right now, we're in a quarantine. And because of the quarantine, the social experience of going out has changed drastically. When we come out of this quarantine and COVID finally calms down, if it ever does, how we interact with each other outside is going to change. Right now, everybody's inside. So everybody's doing everything digitally and online, and we're all growing, which is great. But eventually we're all gonna go back outside because humans still gotta touch and experience each other. And when we do that, it's gonna be new experiences. And this is something that Nipsey said that needs to be implemented, and it's gonna be implemented by other businesses. This man said he's gonna set up his own retail network. When you drop an album on iTunes, them niggas take 30% of a sale. You sell an album for $10, you only gonna get $7 on that bitch. Why? Because you're using their retail platforms. iTunes is already on the phone. Amazon, when you type shit into Google, most people already got an Amazon account. They shit pops up. They can hit quick pay. Boom, you get that sale. You're paying for their retail network. You're paying for the convenience of it. But eventually, you're going to need your own retail network if you're a true entrepreneur, if you're a true musician, you're a true business person. What Nipsey was going to set up was eventually he wasn't going to have to release his music on Spotify or Apple Music or iTunes or any of that. You're going to be able to get his shit from his stores. You're going to be able to get his shit from the clothes. So anytime you bought a t-shirt or a hoodie or some pants or something, you kept that tag. The tag is on there. You scan that bitch with the Marathon app. And you're going to be able to get new content, get his new albums, get his new documentaries. Nigga, that's genius shit. That's next level shit. You were insulating and keeping everything within yourself. You're aligning yourself vertically as opposed to spreading yourself horizontally. Right now, I'm talking to y'all on a social media platform that I don't own. All the eyes is here, which is great. But y'all go to my website, groupa2music.com. I own that. Y'all go to my website, groupa2media.com. I own that. So that is where I really get ownership of y'all and y'all data. Not owning on some slave shit, but nigga, you know what I'm saying. As opposed to me just living on Instagram or just living on YouTube or just living on Facebook. Eventually, we got to set up our own shit. And that's what this man was doing, man. This nigga was releasing content through clothes. Nigga, Apple don't even do that shit. Shit's crazy, man. They took this nigga out, man. That's some bullshit. This nigga was on some next level genius type shit. I'm going to just say this to every independent artist out here, to every entrepreneur out here. We got to continue this man's legacy. I hate that we got to make him a martyr, but he was a martyr for independence, for independent business folks, for independent musicians, for anybody who wants to be self-made and do shit on their own, man. Nipsey gave us a fucking blueprint. We got to live that shit out. We owe it to him and his legacy and his family. If you got gifts, you need to maximize that shit. I got business gifts. I'm going to maximize this shit. I watch some of this niggas every day. Every fucking day, I watch some. That shit inspires me, man. You need to be doing the exact same shit. If you don't want to do it for yourself, do it for Nipsey. You ain't got to be a fan of his music. You ain't got to be a fan of rap or gangbanging or whatever it is. The nigga was so much more than that, man. They took this nigga out. Him and Kobe, nigga. Mamba mentality, marathon continues. I'm out the pond. Y'all stay true.
Music.com.